Back now with that massive sinkhole wreaking havoc in Florida over the weekend. Two homes destroyed after the ground just opened up. ABC's newest correspondent, Victor Oquendo, is near the scene in Lando Lakes, Florida. Good morning, Victor.
Good morning, Robin. Crews have been very busy. One of the first things they did, set up a perimeter. They put this fence up. They took down part of it to give us a better look this morning. As you take a look, there's that sinkhole just feet away from where we're standing. And now as we look above from our drone, you can see all the debris inside part of the house that's left standing, that green bathroom, all that roofing, even a boat. And crews are being told they have to wait a few more days until they start the cleanup process.
This morning, a massive sinkhole just north of Tampa, Florida, swallowing and destroying two homes. Watch the moment neighbors capture this roof come crashing down. The sinkhole now stable, officials say. Five homes remain evacuated, but now the big concern, water contamination. Officials testing the drinking water of at least 15 homes in the area.
How long before life returns to some kind of sense of normalcy?
We're probably looking at several months before we can get this back to situation normal for these folks.
Pasco County emergency officials calling it the biggest sinkhole in at least three decades. The gaping sinkhole is 225 feet wide and 50 feet deep. You can see from our drone all that's left of a bathroom, roofing, and even a boat. A disaster area now filled with mud, sewage and toxic debris.
I see a big hole and I see a lake and I see that we're in the middle of it, and that's probably not a good thing.
Sinkholes occur when limestone underground gets eaten away by water, creating a cave, and the weight above becomes too heavy.
Eventually the arch roof gets so thin that it can't handle the weight of what's above it.
While this one outside Tampa is unusually large, sinkholes are a common problem in Florida, more than 3,500 spread across the state. According to the United States Geological Survey, over the last 15 years, sinkholes cost at least $300 million in damage per year on average nationally. However, since there is no nationwide tracking of sinkholes, they believe that number may actually be higher.
The water levels have come down by a few feet, but there's actually a car that's sitting underneath the surface that might be plugging the sinkhole. The cleanup process will take some heavy equipment, dump trucks, possibly even cranes, and officials want to make sure that the ground is stable before they get that process going. It will likely be months before this area is back to normal. Robin?
All right, Victor, thanks so much. Every time I see a video like that.